session today, and yeah, we're gonna do logistics, how to evaluate that. Certainly, like the sound indicators you mentioned, like the environmental pollution is also very important. I so far they may not be fully discussed because like the it's kind of continuous evaluation, so maybe they just follow the 10 years ago like the old standard, but I guess maybe in the future they will increase in the new indicators. Okay, so far the latest survey results is on 2018. Yeah, 2018. Because this year they haven't finished the report. Maybe next year you will see the 2020. Alright, okay, so let's guess another quick guess. Who is ranking number one on 2018? Which country? Anyone want to guess?
Dubai.
Singapore.
Holland.
German. Okay, German.
Amsterdam.
As I mentioned in the first week, my course I like to show lots of data for you because I think this is more objective. You can at least they have a standard to help evaluate something. So ranking number one is Germany. The overall score is 5. So if someone can reach the 5, it's top score. Germany ranking number one around the 4.19. That's good. And they have the different terms. So for example, custom, infrastructure, something. You can see Germany have a little bit relatively lower scores in international shipments. But if you want to look detail inside, this is the 6th category. Actually, every category are supported by the lots of sub-indicators. So when they give this term. So for example, ranking number two, Netherlands. Anyone want to see your home country? Indonesia. I found so far we still find Hong Kong here. Yeah, 2018, I think Hong Kong still on the very company. But unfortunately, maybe 2020 will be relatively slow down. Okay, we haven't seen the, let's see where it's located. Let's see.
Taiwan.
Taiwan is ranking around 24. Okay, Korea, 23. For Czech Republic, my country
comes.
Thailand, we found Thailand here.
No.
Okay, Malaysia. Okay. Slovenia. Oh no, not Europe. Okay, let me check. You can quickly see.
你们发?
Argentina, Vietnam, 45. Indonesia. Still fine. 160 countries. So if you don't pay me on the 50 yuan, I say okay, at least you are the top 1/3. Don't worry about that. Okay, what else countries you want to look for?
Mongolia.
Okay, let's see for how long we will find
Mongolia
out.
Mongolia doesn't have a port, right?
I think we find Kenya and the Philippines and Serbia, Peru. Okay, not yet. Okay. Well, it's interesting to at least know something here. If you found someone you think you are amazing, fine. Right? Not yet, right? You're working on Well, I would say something for the Mongolia just because it's a little bit inland and not a major port to support us. Maybe. So far. not yet. Let's see.
We're almost finished, but...
Okay, 129. Still okay, yeah, another final. We guessed who is the top one. Now, we want to guess who is the ranking, the final one.
The final one.
Last? No,
let's see. Okay, let's see the result. It's very difficult to guess, actually. Are you a see? Because after the earthquake on 2008, the economy is relatively bad. And you will see, but basically, that's the whole situation. And if you want to look this detail inside, for like just click inside, it will tell you what's the detail inside. But this is a good database that I like to recommend to you, just because they not just have the 1 year survey, every 2 years, you see like the so far they have 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6. They have 6, 10 surveys. So you can easily check what's the trend and after across the different time in your country. And also you can see, for example, if you're standing, let's look at Taiwan's case. Taiwan ranking 24 so far. Looks fine, but if you look in detail inside, then if I were a government, I would try to see which part I can easily to improve. Or I want to, what kind of budget I want to invest to make increase something. For example, our custom is still relatively lower than the top one, you see. So then we will see how to increase that, boost that. And I guess recently the final two terms are very important right now. The real-time tracing and also timeliness. They are linked to each other, actually. So timeliness means like how, but so far, I think Taiwan performed very good here. And this, all others, supposedly we have a good way, long way to go. Infrastructure is still fine. So if you are highly interested with your country, you can go back to check. Okay, let me quickly ask you, you can go back to check. I will already on it. But you can quickly guess who is ranking number one in 2020. Quite different. You see, previous 6 survey without COVID-19 looks very... only one, maybe you can observe the difference between only 2010, just right after the financial crisis. The trend will be quite different, but 2010 will be back to the normal. So you will see the trend quite different. But then, even though we haven't seen the results reports on 2020, but you can guess what happened. So maybe next year, you can go back to this website to check again to see what's going on. And what else can be revealed by this website? This website not just look at the scores, they will help you to know what's going on around the world, and they will have a different like the comparison. So they will tell you who is the leaders among the world, who is the top 10 so far. And this is the 20, Germany still ranking number one 2 years ago and so far. So they will also tell you some high income countries, so we call it developed countries, how the performance will look. And also they will compare with some developing countries to see what's going on. Certain different countries have a different condition. So we can observe the situation with that. And those kind of performance can determines like the next decade, how government can invest to increase your performance. So these CAT indicators just give the government some like the reference with that. And okay. They have lots of trends, but before that, I'm back to here. Okay, so I just want to share something with you. Before we go through details for the LPI Logistic Performance Index, I would like to quickly share something, discuss something here. I have no time to go through revenues, but just I want to let you know what happened around the world. This is one news, Walmart is in Japan. Previously, they want to join the Japan department store system. So this is very famous chain, supermarket and chain department stores in Japan. But Walmart eventually decided to quit after they spend like 15 years money and time, or 16 years. So actually 16 years. So you can go back home to check what's going on. And also, not just for the Walmart in Japan. This is a Sears, another famous like the chain department stores in the United States. They go bankruptcy and go liquidation, and perhaps you can even guess what's going on. I mean, even though without the COVID-19, what happened? Physical stores become a little bit weakness among the new logistics supply chain world. Most of people like to pursue the e-commerce, especially for this year, under the COVID-19, maybe less and less people want to shopping through the physical world. So, which means very difficult to support those kind of physical supermarkets, physical department stores. So you can see, no matter Walmart or like the Sears, they go liquidation. It's not a good situation, but perhaps maybe during the midterm exam, I will ask you this situation. If you were a manager for Sears, how will you do next time? We don't have time to go into the discussion, but just want to let you think. If you are a manager for this kind of physical chain supermarket store, physical department store, how will you sustain your business? Or just like that? Well, it's kind of like a tough question. I mean, what's the future for those kind of physical channel operation we call channel? Because like maybe traditional channel always based on those kind of physical stores to support us. Right now, although we have an e-commerce, can you want to guess how many percentage for e-commerce in Taiwan right now? Compared to the market share rate versus the physical store. Let me show you some number. Less than 20%. Maybe in general around only 10%. So you can imagine your daily life. Not everyone goes to the online shopping. I asked a similar question yesterday, how frequently you shop online. Most of the classmates told me like maybe few times per year. Like, so you can see like the young, anyone here shopping online every day? Definitely not, but perhaps you will visit the physical stores nearly every day. So you can imagine that in general, compared to market share rate, e-commerce still a relatively weakness. They are blooming, but still not yet so blooming. But this year is quite different. Under COVID-19, you know, people are reluctant to work out. So you will see several famous chains, supermarket or chain department stores that decide to close or reduce their scales. What's their future? Just wait for COVID-19 virus disappear? Definitely not. But how to survive? Any quick strategy you can provide for me? Any thinking? If you are the manager for Sears, Walmart, so for example, like the Walmart case, they spend lots of money, spend lots of time. 16 years is not a short time, you know. They spend lots of money, but eventually decide to quit. If you were the manager for Walmart, would you insist to stay in Japan or just back to the United States? I mean, very difficult. I mean, we can easily observe that e-commerce will become more and more popular. Because like it also related to like age. Different age people may have a different like the shopping behavior. So for example, like think about your grandfather or grandmother. are they able to shopping online? Not that easy, actually. We do the survey also. They even don't have any smartphone, actually. So shopping online for those kind of age people may be quite difficult. But for a young person, maybe for most of you, I think you are still young for me. So maybe you are quite easy to do the online shopping. But think about it. When more and more like people adapt to the online shopping behavior, how could it be for stores to survive? Any thinking of that? Or after, let me give you another number. I always like to give you a number. Anyone to guess? How many physical stores? Really, let me check. But you can guess. How many physical stores closed within the past 10 decades in Taiwan or in the United States compared to incumbents? Maybe we can just link it. We just talk about a supermarket and we just talk about department stores. It's not a big number actually. So you will see even though e-commerce keeps booming, they do not really hunt for the physical stores except for COVID-19. So this year is quite specific and different. Most like the physical stores cannot suffer this kind of like the pressure. Because people are reluctant to go out. So I would like to share this news, but no time to discuss it. But think about that. Maybe during my meeting, then I still will propose these two news again. Ask your thinking how to support those kind of physical stores to survive. Okay? Alright, so after the global logistics, we have evaluated several things. We start from demand forecasting, procurement planning, production planning, keep working on the final end. And we have lots of planning to do, and we estimate profit costs, different level costs to see how they really, if they stay in the domestic or move to the global. Plus means the increase in the benefit negative is enough. So in general, like the how to evaluate this, we always look for like the economic, how they really affect by the global logistics. And several things are very important. So infrastructure, we mentioned this is very important because like if you go details look at the LPI, you find lots of countries they are relatively restricted by the infrastructure. Although those six indicators may not really tie in the details for the infrastructure. But you can see like we call it how smoothly, we call it multimodal. If you look at the video, multimodal means like a transfer from the maritime to the truck. How easy to transfer with that. It's also related how many crane you have, how many crane yard, how many space, how you design, and how automation with that. So 2 years ago, we are visiting tour, we go to a Kaohsiung port. They are nearly, I would say 99% automation. So that will increase the efficiency. So that's the best. Here are at least five typical strategies to think about the global of how we improve with life. So first of all, every private company still pursue a cost minimization. You know, compared to the second strategy, value added, the first one is easy to do. So they will try their best to see if they can reduce the cost. Second one is value added. But what else they can do? In general, we have three other things. Channel integration. I just mentioned a channel because like a channel is kind of how you deliver your end product to your customers. We have physical channel, we have an e-commerce channel, we have the hybrid, both of them. And from response, we just have a time length and tracking and tracing all related to that. So that's strategy. And we have to list several terms we need to care about that. Just mainly for you to think about that. But in general, if you want to plan in the future. So today, if you go back home to look at LPI for your home country, maybe I will give you another question during the meeting again. Like how you help your home country to develop the next 10 years plan based on the LPI scores. If you watch the past 10 years LBS goals, how you suggest your countries or your area to keep sustain for next 10 years? Which part you think is have a great chance to keep working on that? Again, it's not homework. You don't need to turn it in, but maybe I will have this exam during the midterm. And during the midterm, if you want to check, I can open this website again. But still want to think in advance, like how would you help your home countries to keep improve based on this evaluation? So.
I just want to remember some are controllable, some are uncontrollable. So for example, maybe think about Hong Kong case. Political right now become a little bit a major issue, and also some maybe not easy to control. So I try to list here, political and others are maybe not easy to control. So if you want to develop a useful and effective strategy, maybe you can start from a controllable strategy to see how government or how private company can do to help increase these indicators. And those kind of strategy actually all related. So here is something we call it controllable, but you can think more. Okay, I just give you some examples. So you can increase your customer service, you can increase your warehouse capacity, maybe you can enhance your inventory management, transportation, packaging, something. I can give you, but that we call it controllable. Okay, so that's the basic. Before I finish, I have one more. Okay. All right. Okay, before I finish today's session, several things I would like to remind you. So number one, I also upload the slides for next week. I know some students may be not easily to capture the information I deliver for you immediately. So I decided to give you slides 1 week earlier. So yesterday I have already uploaded slides for next week. Although I will upload some latest news, so next week you will see the latest version. But if you want to know the fundamental information, maybe you can try to download that first. Second is, if you later on you may receive the email from Baby and Jacqueline to ask you if you whether to join the trip. I just want to remind you, if you really want to join that, the real ticket for our Taiwan real administration, the policy is quite different. Right now we can book the ticket 28 days before. So November 20 is really close. So you better to think about it. Okay, we plan to departure in the early morning, 7:10 a.m. in the GJ station, not too late. Zodo station. So I think bag should be much easier, because bag you may not really need to purchase the bag ticket, because it depends on how when you arrive in the event. Better you purchase the first early morning tickets. And the third one is, I received some students journal paper topic, but so far like most of you haven't emailed me, so I will make a list later, but so far I only received 3 or 4, so if I collect more, I will try to make a list and put it in the internet system. So if you found, I think it's very rare trend on the same paper. So just in case, I will let the first one to propose that. And final thing I would like to remind you is, during, because we have so many classmates here, maybe I will ask some volunteer to 1 week earlier to make some presentation, and perhaps I will give you a little bit incentive, maybe for very few actually, 1 or 2 points, like if you want to be a volunteer to present your paper. Just because like the past few years, we always have, you know, it's a kind of long presentation, since we have so many people, everyone just, even though I just give 10 minutes without any, without any discussion, you need to spend like around like 5 years, 5 hours. Sorry, I've used too long. Sorry. 5 hours. So you can think about that. Perhaps cut down half and half would be better, but it depends. I mean, first of all, I think if you are a volunteer, that would be great. You can go earlier. But if everyone still want to stay in the original day, it should be fine because our syllabus is coming in that day. So I still want to give some chance. So I will
ask your see if how many of you want to be the volunteer to be the 1 week earlier to make a presentation. But still, I need your paper, journal paper title. So if you still have trouble to look for the journal paper, I mean, you can try to discuss with, I don't know, Candy or Betty or Jacqueline, or see if they can help you to search a good journal paper. But better to start, because limited time. Based on my syllabus, you only have around 1 month to well prepare your journal presentation. And some of you are like the first time to make the presentation in English. That'll be fine. Well prepare your slides. I think that'll be great to help everyone realize what you deliver during that time. And if we have successfully separated two groups, then we can go our plan B. You can share some your favorite song with your home country. If everyone still needs to stay in the original day, maybe we don't have time, too much time to share with that, but we can discuss that later. Just want you to think in advance, see who want to be the volunteer to present your paper 1 week earlier. Okay, so several things. And within the 10 minutes or 12 minutes, what kind of stuff do you need to present for that journal paper? Anyone have any thinking? Let me give you some quick suggestions. Since you have a limited time, so better to tell me a journal title certainly and the reference, which journal you find out these papers. So quickly talk about the research question, mainly based on the abstract. Why they propose this research question and what kind of research gap they may have based on the literature review you found previously they done something, but this paper they found something new. And then what's the result? If you found your paper have some tables and figures, better to spend time to explain that. Okay? And then after reading these papers, what's your thinking? Perhaps you can criticize these papers. You found this paper is not like fully correct. You have your own thinking. You can evaluate something. Like if you continue these papers, maybe what kind of things you want to do. So if you haven't determined your thesis topic, maybe this is a good training. Reading up one paper, so you can find out some interesting follow-up. Maybe your own thesis topic will jump out. Okay? Any questions or comments based on this? Please.
Do we need to skip the method or we need to explain the method?
It depends. If you have enough time, then you can quickly tell everyone what kind of method they mentioned that. Everyone is supposed to have 10 to 12 minutes. So it depends on how you organize your slides. Certainly you can describe the method for 10 minutes, but it's not a way. Yeah, you can try to see how to organize your slides in different parts. And I just want to give you some quick suggestion how to well prepare this midterm presentation. You can practice at home, just one more reminder, I know some domain students, they tend to put lots of words on the slides and read one by one. I think that's for the, try your best to don't do that, okay? Or you can have limited words on the slides and well prepared by your other way, but don't read one by one because it's a little bit tedious. So try to avoid that. And if you still have time, maybe you can make your decoration for your slides. You can have lots of animation, I don't know, fly over all the way, but try your best to make the presentation more easy, funny, and more interesting, and then we will evaluate that. In general, I will evaluate your presentation based on several terms. Number one is content, how you organize your slides, what kind of stuff you will prepare, how you explain these papers, how you introduce these papers. So maybe this is one major part. The second part will be relatively minor, depends on your oral presentation, because not everyone is good in English. So maybe minor, but still come number two. Number three will be how creative you are thinking. So at the end, maybe you criticize these papers, I will see how you are thinking. Your personal logic thinking after reading the whole papers. But still, if you have nothing specific, it's fine. But if you can have a bonus. Okay, so three main parts. I try to evaluate your midterm presentation. So main part is the content. how you organize your slides, how you decorate your slides, but that will be the overview call like this first part. The second will be the oral presentation part. The third one is like the criticize part or follow-up suggestion. Okay, so hopefully everything is clear. So any questions or comments for today's session? I also upload the next week's slides so you can read first if you need.
Individual.
Midterm is individual. Final term is group. We have a midterm presentation to one by one to present the journal papers. And final term project, you can extend whatever. For example, I just asked you like the Sears or Walmart case. Perhaps you can, or New Naphtha, you can spend some time to focus on one topic related to this course, but not limited to the news I share. I mean, you can try to specify one topic and tell more details and tell everyone how you develop some interesting strategy. So I would call it kind of like enhancing, improving the discussion. So final term project, I need a group. And basically, group may be mixture. So I wish like have a different countries mixture in this. And the leader must be guaranteed like everyone has a chance to say to present something. I don't want like one leader to finish everything. I don't want to do that. I want to have the reasonable workload for everyone. Okay, clear? Everything around 3 to 5 should be fine. You can have 3, 4, 5. If you have 6 people, perhaps you can divide it by 2. Okay? Any questions, comments? No? Then I would like you free today. And see you next Friday. Thank you.